Hey guys, it's Kim here. Welcome back to my channel. And what a year it has been. This year has gone by so quickly, just zoomed by, and quite a lot of things have changed for me. So pretty much I got a new job, I bought an apartment with my boyfriend, so we're just trying to slowly move on with life, so things have been looking up for me. So let me know in the comment box what your New Year's resolution is. I don't really set New Year's resolutions because I know I never follow on with them. But for next year, what I really want to do is to make more videos more often and also blog more often. I know this year I just neglected my blog, which is really bad, but hopefully next year I will be blogging much more often. Since today is the last day of 2014, I decided to make a video showing you guys my favorite beauty items of this year. So this year I've actually been really obsessed with Korean makeup, so I've got quite a few new Korean items to show you guys. So hopefully this video will show you guys new items if you want to purchase some new makeup. So let's get started into the video. So first, I'm going to start off with the face products. This item I've showed so many times, but I absolutely love it, so I'm going to show it again. This is the Mamondo Real Skin Founder. And pretty much this is just a foundation, and it is so good because the coverage is great, it's so moisturizing, lasts the whole day, and I really love how it looks on my skin. So as you can see, I already hit pan, and I've been using this almost every day. It's just much more lighter than foundation, so I find that sometimes foundation just kind of looks a bit cakey, but this does not look cakey at all. Perfect for everyday makeup. It's super smooth and it's so easy to apply onto your skin as well. Also feels really light on your skin, and I think it's really great for people with like a yellow undertone as well, because I find it's very difficult for me to find a foundation that suits me. So definitely this item, I've been loving it so much. I received this as a gift from my friend Sunny Dahe on YouTube, so definitely check her out as well. Next, I've got some face mists, and I've been loving face mists lately because it just gives you such a nice glow onto your skin after you've done your makeup, and doesn't make you feel oily at all. I've been trying to figure out for ages how the Korean pop stars and Korean actresses get that really glowy, dewy looking skin. And yes, I just found that if you just use a mist, it's so easy to achieve that look. So I've been using face mist pretty much every single time I've done my makeup, and it just gives you such a nice finish. So the first item that I've been absolutely loving is the MAC Fix Plus. So I got this when I was in America. I was actually only going to buy loose pigment, but then the sales lady told me to buy this as well because it would just make your eyeshadow stand out more. And I was in a rush that day, I didn't really have time to talk, so I was like, okay, I'll take it as well. I didn't really think about it, I kind of just left it in my drawer for about a year and a half. Until recently, I started using this again, spraying my face after makeup, and I absolutely love the end result. So Definitely check this out if you just want that really dewy, glowy looking skin. Another face mist I've been loving is the Myogi Hex Aqua Sublime 24 Hour Mist. Usually I have this in my bag, and then whenever I need some hydration on my face, just pull out of my bag, shake it up, and then spray it on my face. I can spray it on top of my makeup as well, and it will be completely fine. I find that my face tends to get really dry or a bit stressed out when I'm working or when I'm just going out during the day. So I just find this is so refreshing for your face. It just makes you feel so much better, makes you feel so much more hydrated, and it's also a really gentle product on your face as well. And another mist I've been loving is the Innisfree Green Tea Mineral Mist. And I got this from my friend when she went to Korea. I really wanted to try this out because I've heard so many good things about this, and this is really good. It's so moisturizing on your skin, and it gives you that really dewy, nice glow as well. And I find this is also awesome to carry around with you because it's just a small packaging, and also when your face just feels like you need some hydration, just spray this all over your face. Even though you've got makeup on, it's fine, and it just gives you such a nice finish, and also makes your skin feel so refreshed and makes your skin breathe a bit. Now let's move on to some eye products. So the first item I'm going to show you guys from the eyes is the Clio Cure Black Brush Liner. And I absolutely love this eyeliner. I've heard good things about this eyeliner, but I was never that interested to try out new eyeliners because usually I use the Dolly Wink liquid eyeliner, and I'm perfectly happy using that, and I've been using that for a couple of years now. But I find that this eyeliner is much better than the Dolly Wink. The Dolly Wink, sometimes it does smudge a bit when your eyes water a tiny bit, so kind of annoying. But this is awesome because I put this on my eyes the other day and I accidentally rubbed my eyes. I forgot I had makeup on, rubbed my eyes, and I looked in the mirror and my makeup was still intact. It was not smudged at all. With this eyeliner, it is super waterproof. It's also super easy to apply as well. If you guys have used a Dolly Wink liquid eyeliner, it's pretty much the same application tip, and it's so easy to get really precise lines. So I find this is almost a perfect eyeliner. I think I'm going to be using this a lot more than Dolly Wink eyeliner. Next item I've been loving is the Innisfree Shadow Pencil. So my friend got this for me as well when she went to Taiwan, I think. And I absolutely love it. It's two different colours and there's like a pink colour and a peachy colour. I like using this just under my eyes just to brighten up my makeup a bit. Been using this pretty much every day. So as you can see, I've lined a bit under my eyes. It just brightens up my eyes quite a lot and it's just super easy application, lasts all day as well. So I've got some Japanese mascaras I want to recommend to you guys. First one is the Heroine Make Long and Curl Mascara from Kiss Me, and I absolutely love this. I've seen this so many times in Japan but I never picked it up because the packaging, to be honest, it looks a little bit cheap, so I never trusted this mascara, but everyone told me to try it out, so I picked it up when I went to Japan and I absolutely love it. I can't believe I never tried it out before. It is awesome, makes your lashes look super long, great volume, and holds a curl really well. What I don't like about it, sometimes it does smudge a little bit onto your eye makeup, so you might have to redo it a bit, but other than that, an awesome mascara. Another mascara that I absolutely love is the Majolica Majorca Lash Expander Edge Meister. So this came out in Japan, I think, early this year. So I picked up this one and there was another version as well, the green version. But the pink version is so much better. It just gives you such great volume, such great length. It's so easy to apply and it does not smudge as well. The pink one is really good. The green one is not that great. So I definitely recommend you try out the pink one. It makes you look like you're wearing false lashes as well. The green one, I don't think is that great because I find it doesn't really give you much length and the volume's just a bit doesn't hold a curl very well as well. So yeah, definitely check this one out if you can. Next are some cheek products. So this first one is the Cushion Blusher from Peripera. I absolutely love this. Packaging is so adorable. It's so easy to apply, so it's great to put into your makeup bag and then just apply this whenever you need to on your cheeks. A lot of my blushes I have, you need a brush to apply on the blush, and it's a bit annoying because you don't want to carry brushes around with you when you're going out. Definitely this blush is so convenient to carry around with you because you don't have to carry around brushes as well, and it's so easy to apply. I absolutely love the color. It's so pigmented and it also gives you a really nice glow in your cheeks as well. Now let's move on to lips. The first item is a Jill Stewart Lip Blossom. I absolutely love this. When I first saw this in Japan, I knew that I had to have it because the packaging is so gorgeous. It's got a mirror in here and then your lipstick. I mean, the mirror is really small and it's probably something that you wouldn't use often, but if you forget a mirror like I always do, it is so convenient because even though it's small, it just magnifies your eyes quite well. You can use this just to apply your makeup if you are really desperate. So a lot of times I don't carry around a mirror with me and this is just perfect for that. It's a tiny mirror but it works really well and the packaging is just super super gorgeous. So I absolutely love Jill Stewart items. The lipstick itself is actually really moisturizing as well. So yeah, definitely check that one out. Next two lip products, I actually have a combination of lip products I really like applying on together. So this is the Shu Uemura Tint in Gelato, and I've also got the NYX Mega Shine Lip Gloss. So I actually love applying these two together, they look really great. So I'm actually wearing it now. Usually what I like to do is just apply this lip gloss just on the inner parts of my lips. And this is kind of like a lip tint, so just apply it on the inner parts and then just kind of smudge it out a bit. And then I just apply this clear lip gloss on top. It just looks really great. So as you can see in the color, I really love this color. Usually I'm really scared of using red lipstick because I find it's just a bit too much for me. But if you just apply a little bit and smudge it out and then just apply a clear lip gloss, it looks absolutely great. So I absolutely love this color. So these two other combinations I used and I absolutely recommend it because I am in love with it. I pretty much do this lip look every day now, so yeah. Finally, I've got some skincare products to show you guys that I absolutely have been loving this year. First off is the Nature Republic Aloe Vera Soothing Gel. And I got this as a present from my friend Janelle when she went to Korea. And I absolutely love this. This is not just for your face, you can apply this anywhere. And I have really dry skin, so I love applying this oil on my skin. And also on my face as well. It's just so refreshing, like it just makes you feel so refreshed, and it is like a soothing gel. It does give you like a soothing kind of sensation on your face. It just feels so great onto your skin. It's super light, super moisturizing, and it makes your skin just breathe. Like I just feel that my skin is breathing and like my skin just loves it. So definitely this is something that you guys have to check out. I love this so much. Next item is the Skin Food Black Sugar Mask Wash Off, and I love this as well. It smells so good. It smells like lemongrass, I think, and it feels so good on your face. This kind of scared me at the start because the sugar particles are actually quite large, so I was kind of scared it's gonna scratch my face if I applied it, But when I applied it for the first time, it just feels so good. You're just massaging it into your face. Then after, if you leave it on for a couple of minutes, wash it off, your face feels so smooth after. Like, I've never felt my face feel so smooth after a mask before. And with skin food, they've always got great ingredients in their products, and it's just so healthy for your skin. So definitely check this one out as well. So that's all for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and hope you guys all had a great 2014. Please thumbs up this video if you enjoyed it and please subscribe if you haven't yet. I want to thank you all you subscribers for subscribing this year and thank you so much for your support. I reached 100,000 subscribers, so thank you so much. It would never have happened without all of you guys. Just want to give you guys all a big hug, so thank you so much. If you guys haven't done so yet, I actually have a gaming channel and a vlog channel on YouTube as well, which I'll link in the description box below. So if you guys haven't yet, subscribe to my gaming channel. I do upload quite frequently on that channel. It's a lot of Pokemon stuff, but it's really fun, and hopefully that the videos are fun to watch. So please subscribe if you like playing games. And then I've also got a vlog channel, which I have made ages ago and I never updated it. I'm so sorry, but I am going to make an effort, trying to make an effort this year. This is going to be my New Year's resolution, to try and upload some vlogs on my vlog channel. So I've got a few vlogs coming up because I usually vlog and then I never upload it. So subscribe to my vlog channel and then I will try my best to upload more vlogs in the future. Thank you so much for your support this year and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!